and welcome to the first episode of the JN Own Sweet Home series. I'm your host, Jillian Jackson, Senior Business Advisor of the Jamaica National Group. Now, today we'll be discussing all things home ownership and mortgage. This is the first in a five-part web series where we'll tell you everything you need to know about the journey towards home ownership. So if you are in the process or thinking about purchasing a home or getting a mortgage, this is the place to be. All right. So welcome to everyone tuning in on all of our JN social media platforms, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube. We're happy to have you and happy to connect with you. So leave us a comment and tell us where you're from or what your name is, and let us know how things are going in your home ownership journey. On this week's episode, we'll be discussing all you need to know before embarking on the home ownership journey. In other words, if you're thinking about buying a house and you're ready to ditch your roommates or move out of your parents' home, then this is the place to be to get what you need to know. All right, if you don't know where to start, this is the episode to watch. I'm going to introduce my guest today. Joining me are Ms. Tanya Lindo, Client Relationship Specialist at JN Bank.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Thanks for joining us. And we also have Gayon Knight, AVP of Sales and Client Services at JN Fund Managers.
Hi, Jillian.
How are you guys doing this evening?
I'm fine, thank you.
Great.
I'm great. I'm excited to talk about our products at JN Fund Managers.
And I am excited to get this discussion started because we want to help as many Jamaicans as possible to achieve their dreams of home ownership. Am I right?
Sure.
Awesome. All right, so let's get started. I'm going to start with you, Tanya. I know in your capacity, you meet many people who want to buy a home.
Yes.
And some of them just don't know where to start. What advice do you have for them?
Thanks for that, Jillian. First thing I would advise persons to do is to save, save, and save.
Agreed.
The other thing is to look at your debts and to reduce or get rid of it, if possible, and also to get pre-approved and to check your credit score or credit rating, as that is very important.
Tanya, that's really important. Tell us, what are some of the tips persons can follow to help with their savings goals?
Well, some of the things that they can do, Jillian, is to reduce spending. That's very important. Okay. And to save any unexpected cash that or monies that they may receive.
Definitely.
They can also try to increase their incomes,
yes,
if it is possible at this time. And some persons can probably look at moving back into their parents' home in order to save on that rent that they're paying. They could save that rent and have a savings account separate from the account that you would be using to pay your bills and for spending.
Right. Saving is so important. I would actually say it's the linchpin of achieving your home ownership goals. Without savings or without a saving plan, it's going to be harder, a lot harder for us to get that goal achieved. So, Gayon, tell us, what kind of investments should someone who is planning to own a home pursue? Should they save or should they invest?
Well, at JN Fund Managers, we're all about investing. And we have a plan that we can develop for each investor. It doesn't matter what phase you are in your life. So let's say you have just left university. We can work with you to develop a plan. Or if you have already bought a home before, we can always work on another plan for you to get an additional home. So there are various products that we have here at JN Fund Managers. We have mutual funds, stocks, bonds, and also repurchase agreements. One of the things that I would recommend, though, is our mutual fund. And the reason for that, it's quite easy to start, and you can begin with as little as $10,000. Can you imagine that?
That's
$10,000.
Great.
So if you're there and you're saying, boy, how am I going to get this house? I have no money. I'm starting at ground zero. You can simply go to our website, www.jnfunds.com. and make an appointment to speak with any of our financial advisors. We can work with you to develop a plan that's suitable for you, because the thing is, the different products are assigned or based on the individual.
Right.
So if somebody has a higher risk tolerance, then we'd recommend a different product. But right. We have a suite of 6 mutual funds that we can use to develop a personalized plan for any investor.
I completely agree. An investment decision is something that's so personal. So it's awesome that you are able to go on your website and with COVID and everything, book an appointment virtually to be able to discuss something like that. That's so important in getting your goal achieved. You can do that without having to leave your house. So go on their website and check out the products that they have and speak with our representative about your personal goals. I definitely support that. So Tanya, earlier though, you spoke about the credit score. Could you tell our listeners why it's important to pay attention to your credit score?
Yes, this is very important, Jillian, because it is the main fact, one of the main factors that we'll be using to determine your loan terms. And So it is important for individuals to know their credit score or credit rating.
Right.
Now, in Jamaica, we have 3 credit bureaus. And every Jamaican over the age of 18 are allowed to get a free credit report yearly. So persons can access their credit report and look at their credit rating and see what adjustments, if necessary, they need to do to improve the credit score or credit rating.
Very important. So, Tanya, just to recap, you said that there are 3 credit bureaus in Jamaica and persons should get their free credit report once they're over the age of 18. So, listeners, I encourage you to go and get your free, absolutely free credit report, because I always say if you don't know where you're coming from, you don't know where you're going. So, knowing what's on your credit score is extremely important in getting a mortgage or any other loan. Tanya, what are some ways that persons can also reduce their debt?
Good question, Jillian. So persons can look at consolidating debts, existing debts that they have. They can also look at the higher paying debts and try to reduce that or pay that off if possible.
Right.
And that includes credit cards. Mm-hmm. All credit card payments or credit card debts, they can reduce those or eliminate them.
Yes.
And they should avoid taking on any additional loans or debts at this time.
Right.
When they're trying to acquire a home.
Right, right. Very important. So that's very good advice in ensuring that when your credit score is presented to the financial institution, that you have a good credit score because you're actively managing the debts that you already have. And it shows that you have a foundation to be able to pay a big debt, which is a mortgage. So thanks for that, Tanya. Another question. You spoke earlier about this. What is the first step in getting pre-approved? Tell us about the pre-approved process.
Okay, the pre-approval is very important because most sellers and realtors prefer that persons come with a pre-approval letter. So it is very important for persons to be pre-approved. And to be pre-approved, it's an easy process. It's free at JN, and persons just need to come with their income verification, valid ID, and TRN, Jamaican TRN, and they signed a credit report consent form, and we can get started in getting them pre-approved.
Great. So the pre-approval process, just tell us again, why is it important to have this as part of your journey? Why do you need pre-approval?
As I said before, because it is important for the realtors and the sellers require or usually prefer that the buyers have a pre-approval letter. So they know beforehand how much they qualify to borrow in and what price home they can look at. So it is important for the home buyer to be equipped with that information in knowing what they can afford before searching for a home.
Very true and very important. Some realtors will not even give you an appointment to look for a home unless you have a pre-approval letter. So just to give you an idea of what you can actually afford, it's an important part in the home ownership journey. So tell us what documents you'll need. You mentioned some of them, but I think, give us a rundown of the documents you'll need.
Again, it's your income verification that's required, valid ID, and TRN,
yeah.
payslips,
right,
and the credit report consent form that will be signed.
Perfect. And I see that pre-approval is usually valid for up to three months. Correct.
Yes.
Okay. So home buyers know that you'll need that pre-approval letter and you should get it very early in the home search process. Well, thank you, Tanya. Thank you, Gayon. I think this discussion was very informative for myself and for the listeners and viewers on the insights that you've provided this evening. Certainly, we must have helped someone to become closer towards achieving their home ownership goals. Thanks to all of you again joining on social media. We appreciate your company, and we encourage you to join us for the next episode of JN's Own Sweet Home. Take care.